January 2020 is the first episode of the 20s. I'm recording 852 Reboot Hong Kong. We're in Central and we've got some bulls behind us. The topic is all about blockchain and I'm speaking to Charles Dossi, Director of Consensus in Asia. Charles, you're originally from France, as we will discover from your beautiful accent. What brought you to Hong Kong?
I came in Hong Kong in 2003. I was in China before. And out of university, I wanted to work in Asia, and Hong Kong was really the place to be.
So when you arrived, you worked straight in finance, because I know you from the early days of online stock brokering and stuff like that. Is that where you started, or?
So I started in consumer electronics. I was manufacturing in China, exporting to US and Europe. Later on, I kind of switched and rebuilt my career, or reboot my career, and moved to finance. So I joined a company launching the first robo-advisor in Asia back in 2015. Later on, I worked for the Hong Kong government as head of fintech. And recently, I joined Consensus as a director of the Hong Kong office to really help all the companies here in Hong Kong to leverage the potentials of blockchain and enable their business.
So tell me a bit more, because the whole kind of blockchain crypto world seems to be going through a lot of very rapid change, right? I mean, when you were working for the Hong Kong government, it was all about fintech as a big umbrella topic, right? And the finance world was looking at it, it was more about crypto. How have we evolved? How is it kind of split between the you know, the crypto security side of, you know, cryptocurrencies and the blockchain world? Why has it gone this way and how does that work?
Absolutely, I think you're really spot on. This fintech journey started about 3-4 years ago. If you look at the event, if you want to get data points, one of the major events for fintech in Hong Kong is the Fintech Week. Back in 2016, it was only 2,000 attendees. Last year, it was 10,000 attendees. So you can see the growth of attention and the growth of participants in this ecosystem. And within the ecosystem, there is people focusing on fintech for payments, fintech for blockchain, and all these different verticals of fintech have been growing very steadily here in Hong Kong. And I focus now on the blockchain, on the blockchain kind of vertical. And in blockchain, we are basically enabling mostly financial services for now to help them to tokenize their business, to help them to work with their ecosystem stakeholder in a more automated way and gain efficiencies and develop new business models. So Hong Kong being really the center of finance in Asia, there is a very strong appetite and a very high level of competition here, which really push every players here in Hong Kong to play their best game always. And you have no choice but to innovate in Hong Kong because the competition is so strong. So in a way, it's a very exciting, very energizing and very positive place to make business because the competition pushed everyone to do his best, and the technology we deploy at Consensus with blockchain really help all these businesses to revamp their operations.
So what exactly are you doing? Are you have existing technology and you're helping people customize stuff, or you're going to them saying, I have an ecosystem of developers and pre-made, you know, out of the box software, and you're selling it to them? How does it work? We're in a different era of the internet, right? The internet started off as very set ways, you developed it, you had a server, then it went into the cloud, and it's all SaaS. We're in a kind of, I would say, the fifth generation, right? Past the Industrial Revolution, we're into the kind of fifth generation of the internet. How do you see, what is it exactly that you're offering?
So today, Consensus is a software product company. So we approach our customers, we understand the problems they want to address, we design a solution with products which have been developed within Consensus over the past 5 years. So in a way, we are a little bit the Microsoft of blockchain. We come with a Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and databases software to quickly build solutions and implement solutions for our customers.
And where are you finding that the traction is in Hong Kong? Because obviously, you know, there's a lot of change happening in the finance world. We've got new licenses going out to, you know, web-based banks. We've got new stored value service providers, new payment, you know, ways of paying through your mobile. Where is the real action? Because there's a lot of talk in the industry, but I don't, you know, you're at the coalface. Where is the real action and appetite?
The real action is in the digital assets for now. So the digital assets are all these crypto native. Think of the cryptocurrencies, think of the tokens which are representing securities. People don't know, but Hong Kong is one of the major hubs in the world of crypto trading. Some of the largest crypto exchanges are based in Hong Kong and operate out of Hong Kong. Think of BitMEX, think of FTX, think of OSL. These people are moving billions US dollar of value every day on their platform. And this is happening here. So these people consume technology and they consume some consensus product in sometimes. But we also have the new entrants, the people managing funds, the people managing real estate investments, which wants to basically work on their products, but in a new way. So they are coming to us and say, okay, I want to digitalize my fund and I want to create digital shares of my fund so people can buy and sell them using new kind of pipes and being more efficient and starting to trade kind of digital shares representing a building, representing an office, or representing a unit of a fund. So this is where the action is. It's building infrastructure, usually similar products, but delivered and built in a very different way, digitally native, where there is a lot of efficiency and new business models.
Interesting. So it's about the tokenization of Hong Kong. Interesting approach. Now, you're obviously, you know, a small team in here in Hong Kong. Is your business a distributed model, a bit like the technology? I mean, where are your people? Where are you crowdsourcing them? How does it work?
So Consensys is the largest blockchain engineering company in the world. We are 1,000 people spread globally between 30 different offices, 800 engineers, so really a tech company. So we work round the clock. We are very familiar with the distributed business because distributed technologies are the core of our business. So we are growing the team in Hong Kong. There is 2 positions open if you want to look at the career page. And we are in.
And the career page is where? What's the domain name?
Consensys.net/careers.
So I'll put that at the bottom, but yeah, Consensys.
Absolutely. We are hiring this week a DevOps engineer as well as customer support
That's
manager.
That's a plug. You've jumped
That's my
ahead
plug.
And got one of my plugs.
Absolutely. So please join us at Consensys.
Okay. That's the first plug. And so let's get back to the second plug in a moment because we jumped. So Hong Kong, I mean, Hong Kong now we're kind of evolving, right? We're part of the Greater Bay, we're part of Pearl River Delta, China, Southeast Asia. How do you see it as a place to run a kind of distributed business like you do? What's the benefit of doing it in Hong Kong?
The benefit of Hong Kong are very simple, but very fundamentals. The ease of starting your business, the supportive tax environment here. We are very low touch in terms of tax environment. The way that you can do business in Asia with the rule of law behind you, you are close to the powerhouse of China, this massive market which you always want to approach, and you've got this ease of doing business. This is really the fundamentals. You start your company in a day, you get your bank account, the tax are very simple, hiring people is simple also. There is just this energy.
Because you're in a pretty cutting edge industry, do you find the developers and the people who understand blockchain are here, or is there still a lot of education to do? It's very, very niche still.
Hong Kong ecosystem is mostly a financial ecosystem, and in blockchain, the financial industry is a very big part of our market. So we find a lot of people which understand the business, and then we enable these people and these employees and these colleagues we have in the team. We enable them with the knowledge of the technology. So Hong Kong is not a tech hub per se, but there is a lot of business here.
Knowledge of the industry. Right?
And our customers are not buying the technology for the sake of buying the technology.
Sure.
We really need to find and shape technology for fixing their problems. So building the teams here, we don't build the teams the same way in Hong Kong as you build them in Silicon Valley, because there is different type of approach and customers and talent pool. But this talent pool here in Hong Kong is unique, and we want to make the best of it.
So you've had one plug. Let's have the second plug of 852.
852. So the 852 audience, I would like to give you some kind of action items. Please join us on the website called Block Kong. This is my personal side project. And Block Kong is a book I'm writing. There will be 21 interviews about 21 blockchain entrepreneurs in Hong Kong. I'm documenting the journey of entrepreneurs in the blockchain industry in Hong Kong. It's an amazing stories. There is 21 amazing people. The book is in the making. It's going to be out this summer. It's a non-profit project of mine. All the money which will be made with the book sales will be going directly to educating computer engineers here in Hong Kong on the blockchain technology. So there is one place you want to go, blockkong.com. Blockchain, Hong Kong, blockkong.com.
Very nice. Merci beaucoup.
Merci.